It's your girl Nene Johns, and I am back with another video to be Queen and Clarence finally addressing their pregnancy. Because you know, the last video they put out, they showed at the end of the video that Queen was pregnant, and now they're finally telling us the tea of what happened. Talk a lot, we're just gonna get right into the video. Just make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and we're just gonna get right into it.
It's your girl Queen Ninja. And this is a video that you all have been waiting for. Is there a lighting here at the channel?
Have we? It's like we have.
Do you see it?
I don't see a difference. Maybe it's like the shape. I know it is. It's the shape. But if I pull down the shade, Patty and Juice won't be breathing. And they've been waiting for us to talk about the fact that.
That you're pregnant.
No, that we're pregnant. No, we're pregnant.
I think it's impossible for both of us to be.
We're both pregnant.
You're pregnant, but with my child, so like.
We're pregnant. Tell him in the comments. You people usually say we're pregnant.
Okay. I didn't know.
We kind of left y'all
with a cliffhanger.
Wondering.
Like, we went ghost after we dropped the sonogram. After we showed you guys a little clip at the end of the ultrasound, a lot of people thought it was faking, they thought it was a prank. A lot of people were like, what the hell is going on? And we kind of went ghost on y'all for like, I think, almost like 24 hours?
Oh. 2 days.
2 days.
We went ghost for 24 hours like on social media, yeah. But we just posting on Instagram.
Yeah.
That's when we was in the studio with A Boogie.
Oh, yeah.
So we was posting, but we didn't address anything.
We didn't address nothing. So here's a video where we're going to address how we feel and everything like that. How do you feel right now, like, about it? What's your feelings?
Happy. I feel like I'm happy that we got to control when and how it came out. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? And that's all we wanted, and that's why we kept it from so many people.
Yeah.
Because we just wanted control over how we wanted to do it.
Yeah, how we wanted to come out.
They want to control how they want to tell people.
I'm happy it's out now, you know, yeah. Because I knew how hard it was for you.
It was really hard, y'all. Let me tell you, like, when we didn't tell anyone, I was in L.A. and I was like, the stylist would bring me clothes that were way too tight around my stomach. And they would like tie these belts around really hard, and they would pull them, and it was like I would be so uncomfortable, and I'd be like, listen, we have to tell this, because I was like, it was a point where I was like just crying and frustrated because I couldn't fit anything.
Couldn't wear anything.
Yeah, I couldn't fit anything.
That happened to you on BET Awards too.
Yeah, the BET Awards, the dress, nobody knows this, but when we sat down, every time we sat down, I kept unbuckling my belt. Like, you guys may have not noticed, but like.
Oh, she was pregnant at the BET Awards?
But like, I don't know if you could have seen the bump then.
Nah, not
you couldn't really see the bump.
But
it was hurting my stomach because now since there's a baby in there, everything is like moving around for this baby to come through. So like my organs, everything was just like changing around, and I had to push all that I did, and it was really, really annoying. How do I feel about it now? I'm actually really happy and really, really excited, to be honest. At first I was really scared because as y'all know, well, I don't know if y'all don't know, I actually went through a really, really bad miscarriage last year, and I always said that after that, I didn't want to have no more kids. I didn't know the future, I didn't know what was going to happen in the first place, but I always said I didn't want to go through it anymore because I thought I couldn't, like,
have any more kids, yeah.
I thought it was complicated for me to have kids.
Aww.
And I was really scared when I first found out I was pregnant because I just thought I was going to have another miscarriage, and it was just a really, really bad experience for me. I fainted twice. I thought I was going to die. I lost so much blood, and I just felt terrible.
Why do you think that happened?
Why do I think it happened? Truthfully, I can't even.
What was going to happen?
God knew what was going to happen before. Maybe he knew that it wasn't the right
meant
time
to be.
for me to have a child because maybe, back I don't then know. I was still in my marriage, and God probably knew that like it was going to end, and I didn't know. So like, I guess having a child, like, I would have never. First of all, I would have never got signed. I would have never discovered. I would never been where I am today, like, you know. And of course, like, a miscarriage is a terrible thing. Nobody wants to go through that, but everything happens for a reason. So
yeah, everything happens for a reason.
Scared. But so I'm just really happy that I was able to get past the 12 weeks, because that's like the safe zone. And like when we went to the doctor the very first time, I was like literally about to cry because yeah, because I heard a heartbeat, and I just felt like I wasn't going to hear a heartbeat. But I heard a heartbeat, and I was so happy. I heard the heartbeat, and you still got the sound of the heartbeat?
Yeah, I'm trying to find it.
Oh.
Look how happy she looks, y'all.
Nice and healthy. How we first felt about it when we first found out. Now, we're not going to tell how you found out. That's a whole other video. How did you feel after?
No, they need to know. I was very shocked.
He was shaken. I was like, shooken up.
I was shocked.
He was crying.
I cried. Hell yeah.
Aww. He cried as soon as he cried.
As soon as I seen the results from the test.
He walked out and he was like.
Because, like, there was, like, things that led up to that time, like, you know what I'm saying? And the whole time, I was so sure that she wasn't, you know? And it was, like, damn. Like,
he was wow, so shocked, like, y'all.
What did you say? You was like, my sperm worked.
Yeah, I was like, I said, the first day I said my shit worked. Because, like, I never even had a scare with a girl. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. I didn't even think this was possible. Like, I didn't think I was gonna, me and you would be right here, right now, about that.
Be parents.
And why didn't you think it was possible?
But just because, you know how, like I've had friends who had, like, scares, like, pregnancy scares and stuff like that. And, like, that's something I never had to go through.
Right.
So I don't know anything about that. So in my eyes,
but you know, don't know.
I've had other, like, I've had relations with other girls, so
well, it just never happened,
and it's never happened to me. So it's like,
yeah.
Well, like, why you? You know.
That's what I'm saying. No, why you too? Because, like I said, I really thought that it was complicated for me to have. Like, I thought I couldn't.
You told me that too.
Yeah, I thought we told each other this before this was even thought of. It was just like friends. Like, I really was like, oh, I'm good. I ain't gonna have no kids. It's really hard because, like, to have CJ, it took me like 2 years. Then when I had him, I had complications. I had to have a C-section with him. So that means I had to have a C-section with this child too. And then after that, like, I didn't get pregnant for like 2 years again. When I did get pregnant again, I had a miscarriage.
Mm-hmm.
And I just was like,
my back hurt.
I thought this CJ was my miracle. This child's a miracle child too, truthfully. How I felt when I first seen it, it didn't hit me. Like, you know how, like, all right.
He was a lot calmer than me.
I was more so in shock. I was just sitting on the toilet, like, no, like, over and over again, I kept saying, no way, oh my God, oh my God. Like, I kept saying it over and over again. I was like, this is not, like, it wasn't clicking, like.
They were so shocked, y'all.
I cried a little bit, just like a little few tears, but I didn't, like, really break down like how he did. And
I gotta say, like, how he did.
You did break down.
Breaking down is like you can't get through this. I didn't break down.
Well, you know what I mean. Like,
he was
crying like.
That's crazy. Like, my whole life just
changed.
Right there, once I found out. Like, my whole life.
And then guess what, y'all? We didn't even tell our parents or Lee until like
for a little bit,
like a week. We kept that between us for like a week. We didn't tell nobody right away. The first people we told was our moms. And then we told Lee after. Truthfully, I feel like me being pregnant just hit me when I
announced
it. That's when it really hit me, when I finally announced it and we put that video out. Like, you should have seen.
Because it's just always been between us.
It's been between us, so we're giving this to the whole world now. Now the whole world has...
We're actually hiding it from everybody, so it's like...
Yeah.
Technically not pregnant. Like, we're dead faking like we're not pregnant.
Yeah, so we're like, faking like we're not. But when we released it to the world, it's like, we also, like...
Now we're going through the mall, the streets. Congratulations.
You know what I'm saying? And also, like, now that we released it to the world, we can't be mad because everybody is entitled to their own opinion. So now everybody have all these different opinions on, you know, what they think about you being pregnant. You know,
we ain't
looking at no college. Yeah, we stayed away from that. But, like, you know, my friends would message, would text me, my close friends, and they'd be like, Queen, don't look at the comments on Shady Room because... Yeah, they was like, don't pay attention to the comments. Like, you know, they would tell me what they were saying. But truthfully, Claire, what did I tell you?
Truth is, we expected it.
Yeah, we expected this already.
Yeah, like, you should know the comments are coming, the bad ones.
It's one thing to, like...
And the good ones.
But I just feel like, we're built for this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Me and you were built for this. It's not... Y'all not gonna bring us down. Like, and y'all not gonna alter what we're doing at all. Like, I just want to tell y'all that, like, tell the haters that y'all not gonna do
anything
that, like, stop this train from going. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's nothing you can do.
You know?
Like, so, like, you might as well just join us.
Yeah, join us. If you can't beat us, join us. You know what I'm saying? Another thing is, I do feel that we may have true supporters that were concerned about my career and the fact that I just started. And they probably just wondering what's going to happen now.
Another person who we told before, like our moms and stuff, was No ID, who brought her onto the label and is like championing us through the building. Like, he's the big guy in the building, you know what I'm saying? So we sat him down and had a talk with him, and like, he was on the same page as us. He was all for it.
We like sat down like it was like big news, like, listen. Da-da-da-da-da-da, we pregnant.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, okay. Like,
we thought that we were scared to tell him because we thought it was going to be a problem. Like,
yeah.
And that was the last thing I wanted. I didn't want anything to come in between, like, her career. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
She's doing so well, so.
Yeah. She's doing really good.
He understood. He said it was going to be great. It was going to be great. And we have, trust me, like, Lee is a businesswoman, so we have a lot of things lined up. Together, yeah, we have so many things lined up that we ain't never gonna have to worry about not making money. I'm gonna be in the process of recording my music for my album. I am touring my EP. I'm still gonna be touring. I think that should start like next month or October. It's like a 2 or 3 month tour. I'm not sure yet. I'll let y'all know. I'm still touring. Ain't nothing gonna stop me from that. I'm still gonna be in the studio, like singing. Can't nothing stop me from that. And I still might even do some pull up for some performances. Like, just because you're pregnant don't mean that you're freaking handicapped. Like, it doesn't mean that you're, like, it's so many people, you know, that probably feel.
Ooh, she said, watch
that
me.
That it's over for me, but I know it's not. And it's not over for Claire either. He got a lot of dreams and goals that he's still going to accomplish with his fashion line and everything.
I got things.
Oh, yeah, he got a lot of stuff lined up. And we got some stuff lined up together, too. So we still, like. The reason why we not so shooken up about it...
Because they got everything together.
Yeah, I feel like we're a lot smarter than probably what y'all think.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It probably looks like we have a lot of fun, and but all we do is literally...
Work.
...is work. Like, work. We're here, we're there, we're in the studio.
You don't even matter where you're home, we still working on YouTube.
Working
like.
Right now, we're doing videos. Working.
I'm writing music.
Right after this, we have to take a quick Uber to go to the studio to work again. And then we're going to come back to edit, to work again. Like, this is all we're doing, and we do this for, like, the little ones. Like, like CJ and the one that's in her stomach right now.
Yeah.
I'm here for her too. Like, I'm a backbone. Like, I would never let her stop working. And I would never let her carry on too much.
Yeah.
So, she honestly, she has nothing to worry about.
I have a good support system.
Yeah, we have a really good team.
Another thing that I wanted to address, you know, I will never, ever make differences between my kids. I love all my kids the same. And if I have 6 or 7, I'm saying I will. I'm just saying, if I had like 8 kids, like, I'm loving all my kids the same way. There will be no differences between my kids. And I'm gonna make sure that they have like a close bond too, because, you know, I've seen some stuff in here. Like, people saying little smart comments under my picture.
Oh, so you was looking at comments?
No, this was recently. I was like, oh, well, I feel bad for CJ when the baby get here. And I'm like, don't even. Because I know how to. One thing about me, the great thing about Queen is I know how to love unconditionally. And I know how to love multiple people unconditionally. So nothing will ever come in between me and my kids. I feel blessed. And you really a deal. We deal for milk for real. Wow. Patty, he a pilf, because, you know what I'm saying?
Patty's,
he talking about something. Yeah, he a patty. But, you know, he, we just got a good support system. Like, Patty, he like, oh, I'm an uncle. Like, he happy. On my side, you got Armand and Trey, they real happy. You know what I'm saying? They talking about their uncles, too. And then, not to mention our blood brothers and sisters. So, it's like, you know, it was unplanned. It wasn't ideal for us, but just because, like I said, just because it's unplanned or it was unplanned doesn't mean that it's a mistake. I don't feel that God makes mistakes.
Nope, he don't.
And, you know, it's just really ironic how we both thought that we couldn't have kids. And
boom.
I'm just...
We did.
I'm very... I'm excited to just...
I know you're gonna be a really good one too.
He looks like he's gonna be nervous.
It's gonna be very interesting, and I would love to see how I turn out as a dad, you know.
You gonna turn out amazing.
I grew up like, as a little kid, I grew up like without a father, so without a father figure or a father, and like I always said, like my kid won't like have to worry about like his dad not being there, you know.
Yeah. I feel like he'd be a great father. And I grew up without a dad too, so I'm just really blessed, you know, that I don't have to go through my kids and I, you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, I want a boy. I'm gonna be honest, and there's a lot of negative energy. You don't see me on the internet saying, oh, I want a boy, let's get a boy.
Everybody team girl, but I understand. But we could bet on it. We could bet on it.
I ain't
bet
on
that. We could bet on it. You really want a boy? What if you have a girl? You're gonna be happy?
Yeah, I'm still gonna be happy with it. And you still have like a choice.
Well, yeah, whatever I have, I'm gonna be happy regardless. Cause you know me, y'all know me. I've thought about girls.
She want a girl.
I have thought about some boy names, but it's just like, boy names be so hard. How do you feel about giving your son your name?
I'm not sure yet. Honestly, I've always, my whole life, I said if I had a son, I was gonna name him Clarence. Same name as me, but
hell no.
Now I'm honestly, I'm not sure.
What is it that you
want to
give him
his own? Because I kind of want to put a kind of like a stamp on his name. You see how you said your mom named you Queen because you knew she needed a star?
Yeah.
It's kind of like that, but you kind of got to...
You, truthfully, you name your kids, like, this is really important. What you name your kids is like really having a big effect on your life.
It do.
And I ain't going to lie to you, my mom... Dad said she named me Queen Naja because she said she seen a perfect stage name and she knew I was gonna be a star. And I didn't see it coming, but here I am. You okay?
Yeah, I was just crying.
But here I am, like, I'm dead turned into a star.
Oh, it's 8 o'clock.
Oh, we gotta hit the studio. We have to give him a great name.
Yeah.
I just said him. Lord have mercy. We have to give him or
her. I just caught that.
With the help of, you know, God and our support system, and we don't care about
y'all got this. What y'all think they're gonna have, a girl or a boy? Like, I don't know yet. I want to see, like, once her stomach starts getting bigger and she starts to show it, then I'll make my decision. But we'll see. But congrats to them, and nothing but positivity, you know, for her and her baby and her career, you know. So yeah, just make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video.